Carl Jenkins is undoubtedly a worldwide success, and he's written for our times.
He's done some, you know, wonderful compositions, and I think people, it just appeals to people.
Adiemus has constantly been, you know, popular since the first album was released in 1995. It seems to have had a great part in some people's lives, which is very humbling for me and gratifying.
I always used to use a certain airline which had Carl's Adiemus constantly playing whilst you were on the plane, and I was instantly interested and curious to who had composed such beautiful melodies, very catchy melodies.
There are many reasons why I returned to the Adiemus project. It's always been special to me, and it's unique to what I do. The invented language, using the instrument as a human voice and not as a conveyor of narrative or text. And no one else does it, and it's part of what I'm known for, really. So it's been a fantastic journey, really, and very interesting. It had to have some kind of concept, and the idea of colours came to me, and why didn't I write pieces in that genre that, through the abstract medium of music, what they meant to me in such an abstract way.
Hello.
How are you?
Mr. Jenkins. Very nice to meet you.
Good to see you. Fantastic.
Very pleased to meet you.
Thanks so much for coming and do this.
Thank you. Happy to be here, and not every day I have the great privilege and the fun to meet a living composer. I was giving the music for two choirs, and it immediately had to me a feeling of sensuality in the music, and already from the beginning and the first chords from the orchestra, I felt it invited the heart and the soul to dance in a very cadenced way. The language is this invented language. It opens to all interpretations, and it invites the imagination to join, but to join in a way that you follow the message from the music, and that's the important thing about it.
When you have people as fantastic as I've been fortunate to have on this, it's a pleasure to be in recording situations with all of them. And they're all a bit different, and they're all kind of surprising in different ways.
The music of Carl Jenkins, which I was originally, of course, aware of, was the Adiemus, because that was such a big international phenomenon. And it is such a specific style, it's a very different kind of style, and I think that's why it resonates in people's minds and in people's emotions in a very different way to anything else. Guitar as an instrument has a rainbow of colors, and while it is not as loud as the trumpet or piano or violin, the biggest asset of the guitar is in the beauty of the color.
...95% of the whole thing is the choir's choral sound. And since 1997, I think, when I conducted a concert at the Helsinki Festival, I found these amazing singers. I've used them ever since, and they're amazing. They can sing classically, but they can also sing what one might term jazz. And they can sing the tribal sound I sometimes use, which is that kind of full-on vibrato-less singing. It's almost a childlike quality in the voice. That's an important element in the kind of signature sound of Adiemus. Wonderful Pacho Flores, trumpeter from Venezuela, came through the Simon Bolivar Orchestra. Well, he's staggeringly good. I mean, I've heard lots of trumpeters, and he's better than anyone I've heard, really.
Las piezas de esta música, los colores, realmente creo que es muy global y muy internacional. Es maravilloso ver cómo el maestro coloca en su música toda la pasión, yo creo, del mundo está puesto en este álbum maravilloso.
Negra, the song I've written is for the father to sing, and it's very, it's black and dark, but not in a, it's a, in a kind of romantic, melancholic kind of style. Cuckoo Rosetta was a gem, and she was worried at first because she sings these kind of dramatic songs, father songs, and the idea of the language being invented. But she soon saw it, you know. I said, sing it as you're singing in Portuguese, you know, pronounce them as you wish.
Here, you really have a language of the soul. It's just words that you don't know what it is, but you feel something when you say that sound.
I hope it's enjoyed. I hope it's sung around the world by different choirs and people. I just wanted people to respond to it and like it, really. I wouldn't write music if I didn't communicate emotionally with people, you know. One critic said of me, he said I was emotionally manipulative, which I think is a fantastic. If I can do something that moves people, make them cry, laugh, whatever, I think it's an amazing gift to have.